Well, hello and welcome to Hot Commodities. I'm Anisha Gupta and the top headlines at this hour are the crude prices rise ahead of the US fiscal cliff meeting tomorrow as well as reports of declining crude stockpiles. The gold prices slip in trade as uncertainty over the US fiscal cliff keeps investors at bay. The sugar prices gain as Indian government issues a formal order allowing mills to export sugar for the third consecutive year. And in the currency space, the Indian rupee rises to near one-week highs on hopes of continued strong capital inflows. Start with the check on the crude prices, which have gained today in thin trades rather. Investors are hoping for a last-minute deal at the U.S. Congress meeting tomorrow. The prices also got a boost from low stockpiles in the U.S., which fell to its lowest in last 10 weeks. And that's the reaction you have seen in the prices, more than 0.5% of a gains coming in for the NYMEX and the Brent crude prices. The gold prices, in the meanwhile, have slipped in today's trade as uncertainty over the U.S. fiscal cliff kept investors at bay. However, there are reports of lower buying, spurred buying from jewelers in at these lower levels. 1655 on your screens, and the Indian markets also saw some decline coming in for the prices here. Let's get in then. Vibhu Ratandhara, he's AVP Commodity Research Bonanza, and also joining us is Vijay Bambani, he's author and CEO, BSPLIndia.com. Vibhu, hi, let's start with you, and let's start with the precious metal space first. And we have seen lower lows being coming into that one. How would you want to trade into gold and silver for the rest of the day now?
Definitely, everyone is expecting US fiscal cliff outcome, which is due at tomorrow meeting. Some of the analysts are expecting this might be outcome of postponing of the US fiscal cliff for the next year. That again quite a bearish for the precious metal prices, because rest of the fundamental apart from the fiscal cliff, I can say investment demand is quite a bit of the lower in the last few of the month. I can say demand from the particularly from the India and China is quite stagnant, or I can say lower in last few of the quarter. So this might lead the prices on the downside in the domestic market. We can say I am not surprised if we can get somewhere around 30,400 or 30,200 level, or in the international market price might be slipped towards somewhere around $1635 or $1610 in the coming weeks.
Who was your sense coming in for silver as well, because $30 an ounce is still a resistance in the market today?
Exactly, daily trend, or I can say in the short to medium term trend, 3125 is the very good resistance level, or and say in the domestic market somewhere around 58600, or I can say 60,000 is very good resistance level. In the daily trend, I think rupee has met a very good support for the silver prices on the downside. 57600 and 56200 is very good support level. Every rally looks like a selling opportunity for the rest of the day.
Vijay, what's your sense coming in for the precious metals? Of course, it's the thinning volumes. The London markets are shut today. We only have Asia, and now the US markets, as they were open to react to. How do you look at the day proceeding?
Manisha, in the leverage segment, I would remain cautious to bearish on precious metals, because there is a clear sign of deleveraging on precious metals. Delivery-based buyers is a different game altogether. I think silver presents an opportunity to basically dig your heels into the counter and start picking up deliveries. I think 57,500 on the MCX would be one level to start getting into silver in the physical market. Allocate probably 20-25% of your funds right now and wait for something like 55,500 to enhance your exposure at this point in time. I think this is a game plan for the next 6 months or more, rather than the immediate future. In the future space, momentum will get positive only above 58,400. And where gold is concerned, I'll have to wait for another 400 or 450 point rally before momentum-based buyers can actually latch on to the buy bandwagon. At this point in time, avoid buying in leveraged.
All right, so do not buy, but buying on dips is a strategy. Coming in for the precious metals then. Vibhu, coming back to you, and what's your sense coming in for the crude prices now? Because on one side, there's decline in U.S. inventories, which has been supportive. But on the other side, there still is that pressure because of the uncertainty in the U.S. fiscal cliff.
Definitely, crude fundamental is quite on the both side. One of the inventory and one of the I can say stocks and one of the US fiscal cliff. Apart from this, if we can look after the technical chart for the intraday or for the short term, I think 49.65 is a very good resistance level. Unless it's managed to breach above and sustain above the same level, I am not conclude to go long in the crude, and I think really could be a selling opportunity for the rest of the day. On the downside, 48.70 is a very good support level. Any breach or any sustained below the same will lead prices towards somewhere around 4700 also in the coming days.
Vijay, how would you look at the base metal sector? Because if you look at the construction numbers that have come in from, or real estate numbers that have come in from China have been positive. Also, the infrastructure development going up by 17% as the report suggests for 2013. All of that seems supportive for that place.
You're right, Manisha, but the prices are not really showing any signs of life, and the overhang of unwinding at higher levels still remains in place. So I would not want to buy at this point in time, although I'm a little wary of even going short, but short seems to be slightly higher probability of success. So what I would do is initiate shorts in the mini futures segment rather than take an exposure to the regular lots. I would short aluminium December futures in the mini segment at 112.50 or 12.75. Hold these shorts with a stop loss at 113.25. My profit taking target would be close to 111.75. Nickel is showing signs of choppiness, and I would want to short the mini futures in December series close to 949 levels. I would hold these shorts if they materialize at 955, and I would expect to book profits close to 941.
Vibhu, how would you want to look at this space? How would you want to look at the copper prices for the rest of the day now?
Definitely, I am also expecting quite a downside for the copper. Apart from the lead, I think base metal pack is quite on the pressure side, and rest of the day copper, I think we can take a selling opportunity in the rally with the stop loss of somewhere around 440. The near term target for the rest of the day, or I can say 1 or 2 days, is somewhere around 431 to 429.
All right, so sell calls coming in for most of the commodities for the intraday market. It's of course is the fiscal cliff announcement, or rather the meeting that the markets are expecting at this point in time. The volumes are low, the London markets are shut today, and as we head towards the year, and more markets will be shutting, and you'll be looking at very low volumes or participation coming back here. Vibhu, we'll let you go at that. Thank you so much for joining us and giving us your commodity strategies there. Let's go for a break. When we come back, we'll talk about the agro space and the sugar prices, which have gained today as Indian government issues a formal order allowing mills to export sugar for the third consecutive year.